Hello friends, today we are going to see the diseases of banana and their management. In that, we are going to study Ciguatera leaf spot, then bacterial wilt, then bunchy top of banana and Panama wilt. So all these four diseases were very important for the banana crop. Now we will see Ciguatera leaf spot. Causal organism of Ciguatera leaf spot is Cercospora musi, and its perfect stage is known as Mycosferella musicola. It comes under the class Deuteromycetes under the classification of Ainsworth Kuhn in 1973. And this Ciguatera disease was first reported in Java in 1902 and later in 1912. It was appeared in epidemic form in Ciguatera Valley in Fiji. So that's why its name given, that is Ciguatera disease of banana. If you see the symptoms of this Ciguatera disease, you will find that the light yellow or brownish green streaks observed on leaves. Here you can see in images, light yellow and brownish green streaks were observed in infected leaves, and these streaks become linear oblong brown to black colored in later phases, and the central portion becomes necrotic and the grayish surrounded by dark brown band with yellow halos. So this is the particular marks of identification to identify this Ciguatera disease of banana. On upper surface of spot, fructification of the fungus appears as a black speaks, and these small spots comes together and to form the coolage and forms large irregular patches. Due to the effect of this breaking of leaves, the rapid wilting and drying and defoliation of leaves occurs heavily in case of severe infection of Ciguatera disease. Similarly, this Ciguatera also affect the photosynthesis process of the banana crop, and it drastically reduced due to defoliation, which results to premature ripening of banana fruits. So this is one of the most economic important disease of banana crop, and it occurs everywhere where the banana crop grown. One most important character of this Ciguatera disease is the spots which were developed on leaves. There are always spindle shaped spots, and they always seen in the chain, so we can easily identify them that is the Ciguatera infection. Primary infection of this Ciguatera disease is always by means of the spores, that means the dried infected leaves lying in the garden or in the field, which contains the perfect stages of the fungus Mycosferella musicola, that is, those spores are known as ascospores, which can cause primary infection in plantation. And secondary infection is always by means of airborne conidia or rain-borne conidia. So these conidia may migrate from infected portion to the healthy portion by air or by water. Favorable conditions required for the development of Ciguatera disease is temperature range, that is 23 to 25 degrees Celsius, along with rainy, wet and humid climate, and poorly bad drained soil or shady areas, and dense plantation and heavy weed infestation. This leads to development of this disease most predominantly. Now for management of this Ciguatera disease of banana, we have to remove and destroy the affected leaves, followed by spraying with Bordeaux mixture 1% plus linseed oil 0.3%. These are some measures that we can do at primary level. And after the emergence of this disease on standing crop, then we can also control it by spraying with carbendazim 0.1%, thiophenate methyl, procrolalose, mineral oil, chlorothalonil, mancozeb. These are some effective fungicides were reported against Shigatoka disease of banana. The next most important disease of banana is wilt. In wilt, there are two types of wilt occurs in banana crop. The first is bacterial wilt and the second one is Panama wilt. Bacterial wilt caused due to the Bucordia solanocerum and Panama wilt caused due to the Fusarium species. So in both of the wilt, the plants completely shows wilted appearance. It collapses and premature ripening of fruits also seen in some cases, and all internally breakdown of tissues occurs in case of both wilt. So we will see the symptoms of this bacterial wilt. In bacterial wilt, the wilt affected plants show rapid wilting and it collapses, and premature ripening of fruit seen in severe infection of this bacterial wilt. Similarly, infected stem shows discoloration of vascular strands with wilting and blackening of the suckers. So this is the particular marks of identification for identifying this bacterial wilt. The infected tissues exudes dirty white or gray-brown slimy bacterial ooze. We can easily identify with this ooze, that means the bacterial ooze. It comes out from the infected portion and it shows dirty white or grayish brown color, and it is slimy in structure, so we can easily identify this bacterial wilt. And the another method for identification of this bacterial wilt is we have to cut the section of the infected portion and put it into the transparent glass of water. We will see the bacterial streaming from the infected portion into the transparent liquid, that is water. So we can easily identify there is the always bacterial streaming occurs in severe infection of this bacterial wilt, and the bacteria comes out from the vascular tissues and mix with the water, so it becomes dirty, shows white or creamy color. So this is called as bacterial ooze test. Similarly, the reddish brown tinge which is present typically in Panama disease usually absent in case of this bacterial wilt. Internally firm dry rot found in the fruit. The fruit pulp exhibits a characteristics dark brown discoloration. So these are all about the symptoms of this bacterial wilt of banana. Here you can see in images there are the symptoms of this bacterial wilt of banana, and at right side on the bottom it is a petri plate containing the section, and the milky white opaque color ooze were formed from infected portion. This completely depicts that there is a bacterial infection in the vascular strand. And if we take the section of the vascular bundle, we will see the browning of internal tissues and breakdown of internal tissues, as you can see in images. So this is all about the symptoms of this bacterial wilt. Primary source of infection in bacterial wilt is infected suckers and infected planting material left out in the field. It serves as the primary source of inoculum, and wounds made through interculturing operations, and from that wounds the bacteria may enter into the plant system. So this serves as a secondary source of infection. Now for management of this bacterial wilt, we have to follow strict quarantine measures and phytosanitary measures that infected stubbles should be collected and removed outside the field, and we should have to clear that the field should be free of stubbles and any another planting material that we have identified that it was infected. And tools which we have used for interculturing operation must be sterilized with sodium hypochlorite or any another sterilizing agent so that the primary infection we can avoid. Similarly, we have to provide better drainage facilities in the field. This bacteria migrate from the water films from infected portion to the healthy portion. Similarly, we have to uproot and destroy the infected plants or suckers. Then use healthy suckers for planting purpose. Follow crop rotation with non-specific crops. Exposure of soil to direct sunlight during the hot summer. Disinfection of suckers with formalin along with water at the rate of 1:3 in ratio prior to the transplanting or prior to the planting. Similarly, we can control the flower visiting insect as they are helping in the transmission of disease. So these are some control measure practices that we can follow to manage this bacterial wilt. The next type of wilt is Panama wilt, and it is one of the fungal wilt caused due to the Fusarium oxysporum Panama specialis cubens. And the first report of this Fusarium was given in Australia in 1874. So this is widely distributed disease, occurs all over the world. Now we will see the symptoms of this Fusarium wilt. The disease may occur at any crop stage, and the most prominent symptoms of this Fusarium wilt is sudden wilting of the plant or individual leaves. This is particular mass of identification for Fusarium wilt. And if you want to differentiate the bacterial wilt and Fusarium wilt, there is the absence of bacterial woods in case of Fusarium wilt. But we have seen in bacterial wilt, there is a presence of bacterial woods come out from the infected portion, so that we can easily identify between bacterial wilt and Fusarium wilt. The entire plant may wilt within 2 to 3 days. When infected rhizome is cut transversely, the disease is seen localized in vascular strands. So this is again the second pathogen, that this is vascular infecting pathogen, and vascular bundles show typical discoloration due to the infection by this Fusarium oxysporum. In the field, the disease occurs sporadically and after spread in the concentric rings. So these are some symptoms of this Fusarium wilt. You can see in images the completely discoloration of vascular bundle and whole plant suddenly die due to infection of this Fusarium oxysporum. Primary source of infection of this Panama wilt is Chlamydospore, which were present inside the soil, and it is a soil invading pathogen. So that's why it is called a soil borne invader. This pathogen also infect through wounds which were present in the rhizomes. And secondary source of infection is always by means of macroconidia and microconidia along with the irrigation channel or the rainwater. These are some factors that we have to study for management of this disease. Now for managing such Fusarium wilt, we have to apply integrated control management practices. That is, you have to keep field sanitation, phytosanitary measures that we have seen in case of bacterial wilt management. Similarly, we have to apply some fungicidal treatments like drenching with fungicides. In drenching of fungicide, we can use propiconazole, hexaconazole. Some triazole group of fungicides were recommended for management of this Fusarium wilt. Similarly, we can also add Trichoderma viridi, which is the biological control agent, inside the cow dung or the manure that we are going to adding into the soil. In that cow dung, the Trichoderma population will be maintained after the availability of food source to them. So that's why this Trichoderma viridi agent or Trichoderma species is helpful for controlling this disease. The last disease of banana is bunchy tuft of banana, and its causal organism is Musa virus 1. It is a viral disease and it was reported in Fiji in 1889. It is also known as curly top strangles or cabbage top virus. Now we will see the symptoms of this bunchy top of banana. Dark green streaks in the petiole and along the vein, which were found in case of infection by this bunchy top. Similarly, infected leaves become narrow, short and chlorotic. That means chlorotic patches were developed due to the infection of this bunchy top of virus. In severely infected plants. Leaves are typically bunched at the apex, forming rosette appearance, and the height of such plants should be stunted. That means the reduced height is observed in severely infected plants. In acute primary infection, fruits are not produced or matured as such plants do not die. So this is all about the symptomatology of this bunchy top of banana. Transmission of this bunchy top of banana is by banana aphid, that is Pantanalia nigra nervosa, and this virus is transmitted to the healthy plant by this aphid after 1.5 to 2 hours of feeding. The minimum acquisition feeding time for nymphs is 17 hours. The aphid remain infective for 13 days. Now for management of this bunchy top disease, we can only control the insect vectors which were responsible for spreading of this disease. So we have to control this banana aphid by spraying with insecticide fosfamidone or methyldimetone or dimethoate at the rate of 2 ml per liter. These are some effective measures that we can use. Similarly, we can use disease-free suckers for planting. If we use disease-free suckers for planting, we will avoid the primary infection of this disease and secondary infection, which was always by this banana aphid, which will be eliminated by using this disease-free planting suckers.